Hello everyone and welcome to our channel The Teacher. My name is Rajiv and today we are going to learn about the SCRLK key. If you are not already familiar that what the SCRLK key does, then here are some explanation about this toggling lock key, just like caps and numlock key on your keyboard. SCRLK is typically used in Excel or other spreadsheet programs, and honestly I have never seen or used it in any other application. Before we go and start typing SCRLK key, let me explain you something. Have you ever compared the difference between scrolling your worksheet from the arrow keys of your keyboard and scrolling through vertical or horizontal scroll bars or from the mouse wheel? And if you have not, then let me clear you the difference first before we start talking about the SCRLK key. Notice, when I move or change my active cell position by using the up, down or left right arrow keys from the keyboard, even though I am scrolling through the worksheet horizontally and vertically, but the active cell is also getting changed. So when you scroll through arrow keys, your active cell, or you can say that the cursor position, changes accordingly. But when you scroll through scroll bars or through the mouse wheel, your cursor position or active cell remain the same. Doesn't matter how far you scroll through your worksheet. You might be thinking that how this is related to SCRLK. I will explain you this in a minute. First, you can find the SCRLK key at the top right corner of your keyboard, usually between the print screen and pause break keys. And if you are using a notebook or tablet, then they might don't have a SCRLK key. Then you can open the on-screen keyboard from ease of access center of control panel. Or you can directly type and search it right from your start menu. From the on-screen keyboard, you can find SCRLK at the lower right corner with the short name SCRLK. Click it once, will turn on the SCRLK, and then you can minimize the on-screen keyboard if you don't want to use it further. You might not get confused that either the SCRLK is on or off. So you can right click on the status bar of your Excel and then make a check mark on SCRLK. You will see an indication about the SCRLK key status in your status bar. So finally, when the SCRLK is on and you move through your worksheet using the arrow keys from your keyboard, the arrow keys start behaving like scroll bars or mouse wheel, and the current active cell remain the same as you scroll through your worksheet. When you need to go back to the active cell or the same position where you were before in your worksheet, then you don't need to scroll back again. Just hold down the control key and then press backspace, and in an instant you will be right back at the active cell. This shortcut really saves a lot of time when you scroll through larger worksheet, and this shortcut will also work if you are even scrolling through scroll bars or mouse wheel. When you need to go back, just press control backspace and that's it. You will be right back at the active cell. When you no longer require to use the SCRLK, turn it off by pressing it once again, and you can immediately see the notification from the status bar has been removed, and now your cursor or active cell will change as you will scroll through your worksheet using the arrow keys. So this was all about using SCRLK key, and if you found this video useful, then don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends.